So here we have the Armatan Oomph. I don't know how that's you pronounce it. Oomph 1407 3850 kV motor. This one was sent in graciously by sodswithquads.com. I'll have the link down in the description, and also there's the link. I'll put the link right up there. Thank you for sending it. I had been wanting to test a higher kV version of the Brother Hobby motor, and so here it is. So it's gonna good to be to add this to the 1407 list of motors, so you guys can compare between the different kVs. So you can see the top portion of the motor is different than the 1407, which is based on this one. As we all know, this is pretty much the gold standard for 1407. Everybody's trying to equal or come close or beat this motor, because this is it. This motor is pretty versatile and it runs pretty much all the props, even up to 5-inch props. People are running this motor on 4S. So yeah, Armatan went ahead and I guess had the what they knew was the was one of the best motors, and they commissioned their own motor with some different features which are pretty innovative, very different from everything. They also have their bigger motors also have these features. So one of the main differences is the shaft. Especially the top portion. As you can see, they don't use a threaded prop shaft, which is the typical where you use a prop nut. You know, put the prop and then you tighten a prop nut. The shaft is still 5 millimeters, but what they do is it's a lot shorter, so just enough to put a prop in there, and it's threaded on the inside, and you just use an Allen screw, an Allen fastener, and a countersunk washer. It's a smooth washer, so the only suggestion or criticism I have here is that if they had a serrated surface here, it would grab the prop more. So I don't think they have any issue right now with the props slipping. The only thing I've heard is when you crash, you hit the prop and it may end up loosening the nuts, not the nut, but the fastener here, the screw. And I do believe they have reverse thread screws, so you can opt for having different threads depending on the motor rotation. But that's the only thing here. If this would be serrated, and maybe on the version 2, on the next revision, and if they had a little bit of serrated surface here so that you can grab the prop better, that would help, I guess. But I think for the most part this works pretty good, and it's a bit different, you know. I guess one of the advantages too is you end up having a less taller profile here, so I would imagine that has some advantages, especially when you. If you crash, you know, there's a lot less lever arm, so it may protect you against bending a shaft, possibly. You know, if you crash, the lever arm is a lot shorter, so consequently you have less forces applied to the shaft. I don't know, just thinking of what the advantage could be. Well, the inside is going to be pretty much the same as the Brother Hobby, except of course this one's gonna have less copper because it's a higher kV motor, but for the most part it's pretty much identical to what you see on the other version, as far as magnets and stator and windings. As you can see, they're pretty neat. Let's get a close up on there. Looks like it's a one piece shaft, motor shaft, and then it's the prop shaft, and then they machine it down to 2 millimeters. So there's where they machine it down. It's solid and it's retained by a regular E-clip. This bottom portion is pretty much the same as the Brother Hobby. Pretty neat windings, single strand wire, looks like. And the usual bottom part of the motor, same as the Brother Hobby. Pretty much exactly the same. No need to redesign that part. So now let's look at let's see how much this weighs. Uh, 16.6 grams. That's with the wires. The silicone wires are about 85 millimeters long. So those, you know, those, if you're on ESC on the arms, these could be shortened. So that's probably about, you can probably lose about close to a gram or so of wire. So I would estimate it at about 15.6 grams, just the motor itself. So pretty close to the original Brother Hobby. The one thing that it is slightly heavier is the motor, the prop mounting hardware. This one is 1.3 grams compared to the just a regular lug nut, which is about 0.5 to 0.6 grams. So that's a little bit heavier. But you know, if it's overall about 1 gram or less heavier, I wouldn't call that a deal breaker. So there you go. That's the overview of the motor. Now let's check out the thrusters. So when I saw the 1 kilogram reading on the thrust stand, I thought I'd better check the accuracy of the load cell. So I used this scale to measure it, and it seems to be good. So there you go. Well, let's look at the results from the thrust test. First of all, I'd like to thank Sots with Quads, Canadian seller of all things Armatan. Thank you for donating this OOMPH 1407 motor for testing. All right, so let's look at the results here on the thrust test for the OOMPH 1407 3850 kV. The motor actually tested at about 3750 kV, a little bit lower. But that's not a bad thing.
might actually be a good thing, because the lower kV will actually have a little bit more torque than the higher kV. So that's, I think that's not bad at all. So and the results really show that that it is not really hampering the performance. So it might that's actually better that it's lower kV in my opinion. So pretty impressive numbers out of this little motor. It just doesn't cease to impress. On the Lumineer 3040x3, we're getting 650 grams at a pretty reasonable current. Again, keep in mind all these tests, I'm using a dedicated power supply, which sustains the voltage throughout the test run. So that's why we get these pretty high numbers on both thrust and load. In the air, once you're flying, of course, you're going to be using a LiPo, which is not going to be able to sustain this voltage or the amps. So, you know, we're going to end up with less thrust and less amps. So that's, you know, that's something to keep in mind. But we'll show us how the motor compares to other motors as long as we maintain the consistency, you know, with the voltage and the testing procedures. So here is the 4-inch props, pretty impressive also, 787 grams. And as we go on to the more aggressive props, the Dow T4045, pretty good numbers at 864. This is one of the popular props for this motor these days. And the one that blew me away was this GenFan 5030 breaking the 1 kilogram barrier, which I didn't think I would ever see with this size motor. But here it is, 1019 grams at 32 amps. So that's pretty high. The motor's getting heavily loaded, so it's probably a prop that I would be careful about running. So if you do decide to run this prop, make sure you check the motor temps, you know, after a quick fast lap. Just bring it down and check the motor temps. You don't want to fry the windings on your motor. So if it's extremely hot to the touch, you know, just don't run it. But on 3S it looks pretty good. Pretty good numbers on 3S. That should make a pretty peppy performance. Same thing with the Dow T4045 on 3S. Looks pretty good too. Okay, so now let's compare against its brother, the Brother Hobby 1407 3600 kV. All right, let's look at the side by side comparison against the Brother Hobby 3600 kV. The first prop would be this DYS 3030x3. We can see some good increase in thrust, 583 versus 556, pretty respectable. Then we go on to the Lumineer 3040x3, which is another prop that is performs pretty well. It's one of the better performing three blade props for 3-inch. 50 grams more, pretty good increase in performance. Then the other prop worth noting is the GenFan 4045, again, pretty good increase. And then the one that blew me away is the GenFan 5030, 1 kilogram, nearly about 80 grams more out of this one than the 3600 kV. So that one really shows that this motor still has a some torque left over to spin this prop even faster. But you know, if you're gonna use this prop, make sure you check the temps. You don't want to mess up your motor. So there you go. That's the quick comparison on these two motors. Again, I want to say thanks to SOTS with Quads for donating this motor for testing, so we can all see how it performs. And make sure you guys check them out. SOTSwithQuads.com. Thanks for the motor, and see you guys on the next one.